I'm going to show you a brief introduction to MATLAB in this screencast. Just kind of go over the basics of MATLAB. When you open up MATLAB, it looks something like this. You've got a couple different windows. The command window, which is where everything goes, and that's where we're working primarily. You have this workspace up here. Once we start defining things, that's where the different variables will go. And then we have a command history. You can see that I've done some commands here earlier. We also have a current folder area. You also see that the current folder goes up here on the top. When we start working with grips, so M files and functions, it's going to be imperative that we make sure that this is set to the right directory. And that's actually a common error. You make a function or a script that you want to actually run, it doesn't work, and one of the primary reasons for that is that you haven't set the directory to where your function is. In MATLAB, you can just type in things like x equals 5, and what you'll notice when I press enter, you'll notice a couple of things. The first thing is that MATLAB command window actually echoes what you put in. You can actually suppress that, so if I want to do y equals 6, you put a semicolon, that suppresses the echo. What you'll notice here on the right in the workspace window is that I've defined that variable x and that variable y. You can double click, and that will actually bring up the variable editor. Right now, it brings up this sheet that's a lot like Excel, where we've got the 5, which is the value of x. If I wanted to change this, I could actually add some more values, and in that case, x would become a vector. And if I close this now, and I go back to the MATLAB window, you'll notice up here, in the workspace, x now is updated as a vector, and if I type in x, it says that x is 542. I can actually go up here. I could create a new variable. So I click on this. It brings up this box. I can assign a value of 7. It doesn't have to be a single letter. It could be things like temperature equals 300, and so on. So let's work through just a quick engineering example. We have a beam hanging off of a hinge on a wall of length big L, a distance x from the wall. We have a cable that's connected to the wall, and this cable is going to have a tension, it's going to have length c, and then we have a mass on the very end. So now we can write an equation for the tension, and what we want to do is we want to determine the position x to place this cable such that we minimize the tension. In this particular example, we're going to use these constants. Back over in MATLAB, I can define these variables. What if we just wanted to determine what the tension was when x equals 2? I can just type in here x equals 2, okay, then I can type in the formula for tension. In this case, I don't want to suppress the output because I want it to provide me the answer. So I press enter, so this would be the tension in newtons on that cable when x equals 2. Recall that what we're trying to do is find the distance x that will minimize the tension. We want to test a bunch of different x values. So now instead of using x as a single value, we can actually just input a vector straight into MATLAB. So I'm going to define x is going to be equal to 0.5, and now I'm going to put a colon, 0.1, colon, 2.5. What we're doing here is we're saying x goes from 0.5 to 2.5 in increments of 0.1. So if I press enter now, I'm not going to suppress the output because I want to show you what this looks like. I'm going to press enter, and you'll see that x is going from 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, all the way up to 2.5. So now I can go back, and I'm going to input that vector x into our equation. Another neat thing you can do in MATLAB is I can just press the up-down arrows, and it goes back to previous entries into the command prompt. So a couple entries ago, I had this formula. Whenever we have vectors, and if we're dividing by a vector or multiplying by a vector or a function of a vector, we actually have to put a period. We also have to do the same thing here after the x because we're doing item by item. And the last thing, we need a dot. If you don't have the dot, it's just going to assume you're doing matrix math. So I'm going to press enter. And what that does is it creates this vector t. And whenever you're working with vectors in MATLAB, they are row vectors and not column vectors. So you'll see we have columns 1 through 6 are here. And each of these values, because we have this 1 to the 3rd, So this would be 4,000 newtons. And if we're trying to minimize that, we can kind of look through here and say, okay, the minimum is somewhere around in here. So this would be our minimum, and that would correspond to x of about 2.1. MATLAB has some pretty nice plotting tools. Plot is a function, t versus x. I press go, and it will actually spit out a plot. So we can see that the minimum occurs somewhere around 2.1, which is what we got when we just looked at that tension vector. CLC will clear the command window and kind of starts everything fresh. You'll notice here on the right that we still have the values of everything still stored. If you do want to erase those values, you can just do clear. So now I'm going to show you how to work with symbolics in MATLAB. The way I do this is I use SYMS, so symbolics, and I'm going to declare which ones are going to be symbols. So M is going to be a symbol, G, L, C, X, and T. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to type in the formula and I press enter. And what it does is it stores tension as a function of those symbolic variables. So this is not quite exactly what we put in here, because you notice we put in a square root, but it's just converting it to the 1/2 power. We can then define a new variable, dt dx, which if you take in calculus, you'll notice is just the derivative of tension with respect to x. And we're going to define that as diff of t, x. And you'll see that this diff is a function in MATLAB. So we're going to tell MATLAB that dt dx, this new variable we're defining, is equal to the derivative of t with respect to x. And if we're working in symbolics, when I press enter, it's actually going to take the derivative of t with respect to x, and this is what it comes up with. If I want to find the minimum, or when dt dx is equal to 0, so if you've had calculus, the minimum of a function is when the first derivative is equal to 0, I'm going to solve dt dx with respect to x. And when I press enter, it's going to go through some calculations, and it says the answer is, and it's got two solutions. So one of these solutions makes sense, one of them doesn't. The negative solution does not make sense because you can't have a negative x. This would be our minimum. If you recall, when we plotted this, the minimum we found to be about 2.1. And now I'm going to say that C equals 3. I can put in formula. And when I press enter, it tells us that the x value corresponding to that is 2.12. And again, we got about 2.1 when we did this graphically and when we actually looked at the vector of tension as a function of x values.